On her birthday, while friends showered her with various gifts, the love of Monique's life fell on his knees, offering her the gift of endless love in marriage. But what did she want for her wedding?
I wanted it to be unique. I wanted it to be real. I didn't want it to be too materialistic and, you know, everything about the dress and this and that. But I wanted it to be nice and elegant and at the same time casual and laid back. I thought it played out that way. I wanted a nice dress. I wanted to look nice. I wanted my husband to look nice and everything. But most of all, what I wanted was that, you know, it would be symbolic of who we are as Christians, and who we are as a person, as persons.
I wanted it to be debt-free when I finish. No, I never want no expenses at the end, you know. I wanted to be able to come out to the wedding without debt, you know, and having all our bills paid and stuff like that. So we budgeted to a T, you know. Because, you know, we've heard too many stories and persons have told us, look here, man, make sure say you live within your means, plan within your budget. And I must say, thank God that everything, you know, got covered, got paid for. I mean, even in the midst of the planning, a lot of persons, you know, chipped in and, you know, gave contributions and supported. Mm-hmm. And that helped us through a lot, you know. We mm-hmm. did our own saving and all of that, and we say, well, really and truly, we are planning for the marriage, not just the wedding, you know. After the wedding is finished, we should be able to live, mm-hmm. you know. And that was one of the main motives in terms of planning.
In planning their wedding, Monique and Dayton were not alone. They share why they felt God was with them the whole way.
We got the videography free, you know, somebody mm-hmm. paid for that for us.
The photograph.
Mm-hmm.
We got taken for at a very affordable. I can't even quote the price because of how affordable it was. And we just thought that, you know, God really provided.
We really never start out with a lot. We really never start out with much. I mean, because the thing is, at the time at the wedding, I think you weren't working.
No, she wasn't working.
I was the only one working. So we were looking to find a place as well as, you know, wanted a good wedding. And, you know, we say, you know what, make us scale down. And then there's some things that really, in ourselves, we say, really don't want to shortchange ourselves. We just have to trust God. So we planned. Mm-hmm. We planned what we wanted. And we pray and we ask God for what we want.
Mm-hmm.
And even when we didn't see it coming, we say, this is what we want, Lord. And He provided.
Sweet, isn't it? But here's what's also sweet. The work of talented cake artist Tanisha Williams.
My passion for cakes started very early in life. My mom used to, every birthday, she made a point of duty to have a cake baked for my sister and myself. We were from humble beginnings, so that was the highlight of our life. Coming from that, the skill caught on, and having gone to high school, you did food and nutrition, you excelled, you graduated top of your class for food and nutrition. And then you sit and you say, what do you want to do with your life? What are you good at? And I said, you know, I love being in the kitchen. I actually thought I would be cooking, having a restaurant as opposed to having a bakery, but you go where you're led. So having gone to UTEC, I registered in the Hospitality and Tourism Management program, where I majored in food and beverage. So that further expanded my passion and my creativity where cakes and pastries concern. So that's really where the passion is. It's really deep-rooted from early years with my mom.
Tanisha shared with us her approach to brides and their unique desires.
Every bride is different, but they all want a great cake. They all want a show-stopping piece. The ones that would come in and say, this is what I want, it's way easier. They know exactly what they want. There's no back and forth in terms of changing flavors, changing design. Those are the easiest brides to work with. The brides who want to change design the last week before the wedding, Those are the ones that's a little bit tricky. You have to be strong, you have to maintain your customer service, you have to be patient, because it's their special day and you want to share and you want them to be happy. So even though it's a last minute change and you wish it wasn't a last minute change, it's just finding that passion and drive and love for your customers that kind of, that pushes you to, okay, I'll do it for you. And I'm always giving to my brides. Some of them are so lovely. I did a wedding the other day and the bride was just amazing. She came in, she said, this is what I want, do your thing, I've seen your work, it will be awesome. And she only informed me when payments are made, when boxes come in, and it was just easy. Other brides are more nervous. Some brides are not sure what us cake decorators provide. So sometimes I'm a wedding planner, sometimes I'm a mother. I had a bride who came and said, oh my God, I'm having a panic attack. And I had to be there counseling. So after a while, you become everything to these brides. And it's really a glorious, joyful feeling. And I enjoy it so much.
And what if you want a wedding cake as unique as you are?
Well, what I normally ask brides when they say, I'm not sure what I want, but I want a cake to fit well with my wedding. I say, what do you love? What's the theme of your wedding? What are your colors? What are you looking for? Do you want big? Do you want small? Do you want texture? Do you want fresh flowers? Do you want sugar flowers? So it's, some brides don't know what their theme is. They just know the color. And I'm saying, do you want a romantic wedding cake? Do you want just a simple cake? How complex do you want the cake to be? So we can look on the patterns for the dress, the jewelry that they may be wearing, and incorporate all of that to ensure that the cake blends well with their weddings.
If you don't have a vision for your wedding cake, here are some ways to find inspiration.
One of the best places to find ideas for your wedding in general is the internet. A lot of brides spend hours searching the internet to look at what the trends are, cakes that have already been done, and they'll come and say, can I have something like this? Some will want the exact same thing. But what I try to do sometimes is say, look, let's work with this, but let's make it your own. Some decorators don't like to replicate the work of others. It's people's work mean a lot to them, and to just go and copy it. So I tend to say, let's make it your own. So I'll change something here, I'll change sizes, I'll change the design, just to make sure that they have a cake that is special to them.
Now into the yummy stuff, cake flavors.
Fruit cake is not loved by my generation, and I've figured that out. I have done more chocolate and red velvet cakes than fruit cakes. Brides will come in and say, I don't like cake. I don't like that black thing. Just make me a cake. And I'll recommend the usual flavors. Since they'll be sharing their cake with others, I tend to say you may want to go with vanilla, you may want to add red velvet, you may want to go with chocolate, you may want to do coconut. You can spice that up with rum, you can add nuts. Do you like nuts? Those are some of the things that I ask. And since they're sometimes on a budget, they tend to go with the more affordable flavors, which typically is vanilla cake. If they're having perhaps a three-tiered cake, which is a trend, everybody, bride is taking, I'd like a three-tiered cake, please. I would say if you're not going fruitcake, you can use three different flavors just to make your wedding cake separate from the norm. But the usual flavors are typically red velvet, chocolate, coconut, vanilla, and fruitcake. Some brides say, I want fruitcake. It still exists, but I see a lot of younger brides saying no. But what they do is then order a sheet cake to give to their guests as a favor.
Tanisha gave us VIP access inside her cake studio for a behind-the-scenes look at making that perfect wedding cake.
So today we're decorating a two-tiered cake. It's a very simple and chic modern cake, and it's a trend in the wedding cake industry, keeping it simple yet elegant and nice. Today we're going to, it has been adorned with gold ribbons, and we're going to finish the design with a few purple roses. So now we have our modeling piece rolled out. We're going to go ahead and cut our petals that we will cover with film to ensure that it doesn't dry out. We'll start with an already dried rose cone that we have. And what we're going to do, we're going to take our first petal and we're going to thin the edges using a balling tool. And this is really a writing motion. So we gently go around the edge of the petal. This will give us a nice, thin, realistic rose petal. We're going to apply glue to the bottom half and the left corner of our petal. We put our cone there and we wrap our petals. We should not be seeing the cone through the top of our petals. So we put that there. We go on to the next. And we get our edges nice and fresh, then we repeat our process, the gluing process. And what we now do, we find where the petal meets and we go down center, keeping it at almost the very same height. We wrap around, then we take our next petal and we tuck it in here and we go around.
Tanisha whipped on a couple more of those petals and voila!
Wedding cakes, you tend to find a sugar topper or fresh flowers on top. But today we're going to go a little bit different and we're going to add it to the sides. And we just stick our noses in and we just add it. There we go. And we're just going to fill that in. And there we have a beautiful, modern, and chic wedding cake.
As icing on the cake, after the break, Monique, a talented interior decorator, shares her artistic vision for her and Dayton's special day.